It's very imaginative in the orchestration. It's very beautifully done. It was actually originally a piano piece. It is a series of, well, let me start here. In 1874, Mussorgsky's friend, Victor Hartmann, who was a painter and also designer of some objects and things like that, passed away. And there was an exhibition of his works. And Mussorgsky decided to kind of memorialize this exhibition musically. One of the neat innovations is there are, of course, 10 different scenes or pictures inspired by that exhibition. But one of the neat things that he does is he starts the piece with what he calls promenade or walking music. And it's music that's meant to depict him walking through this exhibition. And between a lot of the pieces, this music keeps coming back and is varied in mood according to the reactions to the exhibit. So that's kind of an interesting thing. I decided to, I read up a lot on Mussorgsky's kind of philosophy and thoughts on art and everything else, and decided to add a few, add text. Number one, it allows me to collaborate with my dear friend Keisuke, Hoashi. But also, it just maybe puts a few of the pieces into a kind of context. So I hope you enjoy.
Trumpets, fanfare, an exhibition comes to town. His exhibition, the works of our friend, the great artist, Victor Hartmann. May he rest in peace. Thank you. next picture holds in store for us. It's a medieval castle and a troubadour singing of his unrequited love. Twilleries gardeners and friends. All the children are playing. All the children are taunting poor Pierre. who runs off to his nurse for comfort. Well, they resume play, and all seems forgotten. Social inequity. From playground to cemetery, it pervades all aspects of life. Why, look at how hard those farmers sweat and toil with all their might to feed those fat, lazy upper classes. Oh, but these farmers, they're no better. Look. Look at how they treat their work animals. Look at how that ox struggles to pull that overloaded cart through all the mud and the filth and the slime.
Thank you. Thank you. Monsieur de Pussinger has just recovered his cow named Fugitive. But the good ladies of Limoges, they are not in full agreement about this.
Why?
Well, because Madame de Rambosac has gotten wonderful porcelain dentures. While Monsieur de Pantaleon, he is still inconvenienced by his nose, which is as red as a peony.
Creative spirit of the dead Victor Hartmann leads me towards the skulls, calls them. Candles flickering, witch, Baba Yaga, lurks in her hut, held aloft on two monstrous chicken's legs. Oh, she eats children for breakfast. She rides high in her giant mortar and pestle, leading us to the majestic, glorious, great gates of our ancient Russian capital, Kiev. Thank you.
Thank you.